perfect. Okay, guys, today I'm trying something new, and I've had a little bit of success in making bottle openers out of Craftsman wrenches. There's a couple of different styles that I've come up with. This is a full wrench turned into one. That's too hot to touch, but that's a full wrench. It's not too hot yet. Still a little warm. All right, double box end wrench, a little twist, and you read the Craftsman in it. So what I'm going to do next is give you a demonstration. I'm going to turn this into a one wrench bottle opener. The open end will be the bottle, the open top, and then the bottom end will be the pincher for the cap. So that's the plan. And here we go. So the first thing that I want to do is my vulping hammer. I'm going to flatten the outer edge of this into a curve. So that it tapers right down to the point. Just trying to put an organic shape to that. To that little point on the end. Next, after you got that flat there, what you want to do is just put a bit of a curve in that end. Just a little bit, just so it rolls down a little bit. And then on the opposite side, you go ahead and start wrapping your curve. And this wrench is a little bigger than the ones I've been working on, but just to go in detail, put a little hook up on the end, and then I start curving the other way. What you're going for here is you're trying to bring that, end, or the tab part, about halfway, maybe a quarter of the way. Get out there. I'm trying to get this end part about a quarter to a half of the way up the flat spot on the top. So from there, I start going into my straightening mode, get things where I want it to be. I like to kind of get things straightened up, plumbed up before I put the final shape onto it. That's not looking too bad. But for my improvised wooden hammer now, because I don't want to mess up the writing, I just go ahead and bring that down to the shape that I want. And go ahead and true it up again if I can do it on this heat. I can get on there and not to do that. So we're getting close. Alright. I'm still not as lined up as I want. I'm a little cockeyed on the end. We'll go ahead and heat that up and we'll straighten it up one more time. You know, it's only red. Let's hope that's enough to get what I need to do here. Back to the pry bar. I'll put a twist on it like that first. There we go. Perfect. And now we need to move it over there. Move it up. Perfect. So now we're looking pretty good. Looks nice. I'm going to go ahead and kind of flatten the sides on that box a little bit, and then roll that tip down. Now I'm going to be kind of gentle here. Just want to put a bit of an organic shape to it. Nothing too much. Just kind of flows into the... So it flows into the width of the bar a little better. Right, for the last step, I'd like to just put a wedge in here, just something to give it some shape. And I'll put a flatten that nose out. Just tap it down to the height that I'm looking for. Check my alignment. I'm a little bit off on this side. Clean it up a little. Too bad at all. And there you have it. Done. Got just enough lip there to grab a bottle cap. We will let this thing cool down and clean it up, and I'll show you how it works. That's one way to do it. Got them all cleaned up. Made quite a few of them today. Turned out to be not a bad project. Pretty neat. unique items. This is the one that I showed you making. This is the full wrench. Certainly is a beefy item. Go ahead and give it a try, see how it works. Just like that. Works perfectly. Cheers.